want back. Just remember what Shane O'Mac said.
Someone's got to pay.
Shane McMahon is creating a new standard for ruthlessness. Just look out! Oh, wait. There's the Mean Street Posse. They're another one of the street gang. Those rich punks.
Just because you have money, people think that you're soft. You can't take it. That's not true.
Patterson and Briscoe being assaulted here by the Mean Street Posse.
Once in a while, you got to pound a few heads. Because if you don't pound a few heads, I'll tell you what. You're going to be sitting there looking like a real punk.
Well, God almighty.
Boom!
Joey Harris and Pete Gass and Rodney triple teaming pass.
We win. We always win. Nobody else is going to win. You can't beat us.
Hello again, everybody. Michael Cole, Kevin Kelly at ringside. And I'll tell you what, Kevin, the easy way to describe these guys, the Mean Street Posse, bunch of rich punks.
Yeah, but they're punks who are friends with Shane McMahon. That puts them in pretty high standing.
The following contest is scheduled for Woodfall. Making his way to the ring, they're accompanied by Rodney and Pete Gass. Here's a member of the Mean Street Posse, Joey Abs.
And speaking of Shane McMahon, keep in mind, Joey Abs was the chosen one by Shane for his sister Stephanie.
That relationship went awry. Now Test and Stephanie, of course, are engaged. And it was a very touching, very romantic scene. We've all seen, of course, as the engagement took place. It was very nice and romantic. But I'm sure Shane McMahon hasn't forgotten about it, especially after what happened with Test this past Thursday on SmackDown.
And his opponent, he weighs in at 210 pounds, Papi Chulo.
And I'll tell you, I'm extremely impressed with this young kid, 21-year-old Papi Chulo, out of Mexico. What a high risk taker. What a high flyer.
You will see maneuvers out of Papi Chulo, folks, you have never seen before. And I have to wonder, Mean Street Posse, they're tough and all. They don't have a lot of ring experience. Is Joey Abs really ready for Papi Chulo?
And what a Sunday night heat we have for you tonight, folks. Edge is in the hot spot. We're going to look at his career thus far in the WWF. And what about Deja Video?
Yeah, Stone Cold Steve Austin never met a mode of transportation he didn't like. You want to talk about road rage, the rattlesnake personifies it. Deja Video will take a look at some of Austin's greatest moments behind the wheel.
Also a musical look at the week that was for the WWF Tag Team Championship and the plays of the week. Bring it on. And Papi Chulo now set to lock up with Joey Abs. What a wild week of the World Wrestling Federation, and it started this past week on Raw. Shane dangling that carrot, the number one contender status for the World Wrestling Federation Championship in front of The Rock and Mankind.
While Mankind and The Rock both had the opportunity for the carrot, they just continued to get the stick. But when all was said and done, Michael, they didn't get their hands on Triple H. Instead, Mankind and The Rock wound up the WWF Tag Team Champions.
And Papi Chulo now with an elbow looking good in the early going here against Joey Abs. And look at Joey Abs. What a slam that time. Quick cover now. Here's the count. Two and a kick out by Papi Chulo. Rock and Mankind, the new World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions in a shocker. And The Undertaker leaving the Big Show high and dry. Cover again, two, and again a kick out by Papi Chulo.
And I'm still wondering, what did Paul Bearer have inside of his coat that was so enticing? What words did he say to the Lord of Darkness that made The Undertaker leave the Big Show high and dry and eventually cost the tandem the tag team gold?
Joey Abs misses that time. Papi Chulo showing his quickness, caught a clothesline from Joey Abs. Then on SmackDown this past Thursday night, what a war it was. Shane McMahon setting up The Rock versus Mankind. Tag team champions going against one another to try to determine who would be the number one contender. Look at Papi Chulo now. Wow, what a maneuver. Into a Hurricane Rana.
Man, oh man.
It was Rock versus Mankind on SmackDown, and once again, Shane screwing both The Rock and Mankind.
Let's take another look first at the incredible athleticism of Papi Chulo. We said, folks, you're going to see maneuvers you've never seen before, and look out below!
Wow! Over the top rope, wiping out Joey Abs and Pete Gass and Rodney from the Posse. Can't believe it. But Shane got his comeuppance on SmackDown, courtesy of his mom this past week.
Well, when Test hit the stage and introduced Linda McMahon, certainly the complexion of SmackDown changed. If you take one more look, you'll get a Joey Abs view of Papi Chulo. I don't think they have a Papi Chulo in Greenwich.
Papi Chulo hammering away on Joey Abs. Reversal now, off the ropes. And again, the quickness of Papi Chulo. And he fell into that one.
Well, I tried the springboard moonsault there, but Joey Abs, you see how strong he is.
What a slam by... He is more accomplished of the three Mean Street Posse inside the squared circle.
You think any of the members of the Mean Street Posse will be invited to Test and Stephanie's wedding?
Oh, please. When is the wedding going to be?
We don't have a date yet, but, sir, I mean, coming up. Are they going to wait until next summer? Do you think they'd wait all the way until June? Or are these kids just so impetuous, Michael, they can't wait to tie the knot?
Well, there is one thing we do know. Patterson and Briscoe will be Test's best men.
See Pat Patterson crying when he was asked.
He was emotional about it.
He gets emotional like
and
that.
Look at the big man now, 6'4", near 300-pound Joey Abs climbing to the top rope now. And he's paying for it. He shouldn't be up there in that high rent district. Nope. And there's
Joey will get a nosebleed up there. Papi Chulo now. Let's see if he can take advantage of this. Look out!
Oh, man, what a maneuver. Papi Chulo now, quick cover on Joey Abs. There's two. Joey Abs gets the shoulder up.
You think somebody like Papi Chulo would be allowed in Greenwich?
Please, they beat him up. And look at Papi now, top ropes. Wow, missile drop kick into the chest of Joey Abs. Joey Abs in trouble here. Keep in mind, Rodney, Pete Gass, the posse on the outside of the ring. Papi Chulo's got Abs up, flips him down. Hey, this kid is very, very impressive.
Well, let's see if he can follow up. He needs to, I think, hit one more high-risk maneuver, and then Joey Abs will be done for!
Oh, man! Corkscrew from the top rope, wiping out the posse. Man, oh, man. I don't think the posse knew what they were getting into. Especially Joey Abs when he signed to take on Papi Chulo.
Pete Gass and Rodney victimized on the floor, but now, wait a minute, cast across the back.
And Papi Chulo, referee never saw it. And can Joey Abs take advantage here? Yep. Into the posse outside the ring, directing traffic. Papi Chulo going for a ride here. Wow! Hooks the leg into the cover. Hope this one's over. Joey Abs with a big win over Papi Chulo. Give the assist to the posse.
Every day, somebody's got to pay. So say the posse. Today, here on Sunday Night Heat, it was Papi Chulo.
We got to take another look at action at the end of this matchup, helping Joey Abs to the victory. Check it out.
Well, certainly the Mean Street Posse is indeed that. They run in a pack. It took all three of them to do it. With the distraction from Pete Gass, Rodney may have rebroken his arm. Who knows? But from there, Joey Abs was able to drill Papi Chulo center of the ring. Incredible maneuver.
More action's coming on Sunday Night Heat. Stick around, folks. Joey Abs, victorious.
Don't let him in here.
Stone Cold! Stone Cold is here!
Get your guns out!
He's going to crash Big Man's party!
Moonlight is thought to transform some people into strange creatures to drive others mad.
This portion of Sunday Night Heat is brought to you by Henson's Energy Drink, the real high energy deal. And by Starburst Hard Candy, give it some juice. And also by WWF The Music Volume 3. Hear the original entrance theme songs of your favorite WWF superstars. Now available at all Circuit City Music locations and other fine retailers. Now the hotspot showcases one of the coolest superstars in the WWF, Edge.
Is the truth that you deceive, the lie that you believe. He heads for the horizon, like some Spanish galleon's crest. The mysteries of this life unfold when we embrace the edge and then let go.
All we know about this young man is that we are told he is some sort of tortured soul.
Every time I've seen him, he seems to be in some sort of a rage.
Seemingly on the edge of exploding at any time.
He's over the edge.
Look at that!
Oh, Edge.
Oh, dear.
What is Edge doing in here? He's getting some of Gangrel. There may be something in these two men's past.
The blood of Gangrel flows through your veins.
And there you see Christian, the younger brother of Edge. There's Edge. He's coming to confront his brother.
What is going on here, JR?
Watch it. This is a huge mystery.
What the hell?
Edge is helping his brother Christian and Gangrel. And now look at Edge. What in the hell is going on here?
He's calling these guys together. They've been at each other's throats. Now they're together.
They will understand. Understanding is just a matter of time. We are who we are. The unholy trio. Beware. Take care, because the freaks
come out at night.
Moonlight is thought to transform some people into strange creatures to drive others mad.
When the sun goes down and the moon rises,
it's our time to shine.
Some say they don't understand your lifestyle, but if you ask me, it's nothing but a gimmick.
Well, we don't care what you think.
Oh my God! The bloodbath is nothing but intimidation from the Brood. What is going on? The Acolytes, a victim of a bloodbath! Oh my God! Another bloodbath by the Brood! Edge hits the spear.
Edge, great young superstar here in the WWF. Edge now top rope crossbody on Bossman. And wait a minute now!
Gangrel, what is he doing? Gangrel just impaled Edge.
Some have speculated that Gangrel has been a little bit jealous of the overwhelming popularity that Edge is building around the world. Oh, look out here. Oh, no, come on.
Oh, my God! Edge went right down that burning hole.
So Edge and Christian will meet Bradshaw and Farouk for the tag team title. Well, Gangrel is pulling Christian out of harm's way, but that's certainly not going to do any favors for Edge, who's left all alone.
Gangrel just abducted Christian.
Christian is my own flesh and blood. Right now, I'm in disbelief, but I'm also angry. Christian has made his... I guess I have to live with it.
This will be a supercharged matchup. There's that battle. Oh,
wait a minute. Wait a minute, Christian would not get... What a...
Well, Christian and Edge now embracing...
No, I know what it is, JR. Blood thicker than water.
You think you know me. But you will never know me. You know what I allow you to know. You're just a puppet who thinks he's alive.
Welcome back to Sunday Night Heat here on USA. Last Monday night on Raw, GTV struck again, catching PMS's poster boy, Meat, in a lip lock with another WWF superstar's girlfriend.
That's not Terry Runnels.
Wait, that is not Terry Runnels. That's Marianna.
That's
Chaz's girlfriend, JR.
It sure as heck is.
You're busted. Oh!
And Terry Runnels doesn't like that one bit, and here comes Chaz. It was Chaz's girlfriend. That was swapping the slobber with me.
They were just playing a little combo hockey. Oh, look at that.
Oh, my. Terry Reynolds has jerked Marianna down by the hair.
Get back. Ripper Caldo.
The fur is flying here on Raw.
Now let's take you to Lillian Garcia, who's standing by with Terry.
Terry, earlier tonight I spoke with Nate, and he says that he does not regret what he did with Marianna, and that basically you don't own him and that the relationship is over.
Did he now? Well, you know what? You don't know me and I don't know you, but let me clarify something for you, honey. Meat was just that. He was a piece of meat. If I wanted him back tomorrow, I'd have him. He was absolutely nothing to me. How many times did you see me that I looked satisfied, truly? I don't think very many. He was a teeny tiny fish in a very large pond. And I think that I need a bigger one. I'm gonna go fishing now. See ya.
Kevin, I wonder what she's gonna use for bait.
Well, trust me, Michael, if she puts it on the hook, she can reel any fish that
Whoa,
she wants.
Whoa, look at this. Meat headed to the ring with Marianna. What a shocker here on Sunday Night Heat. I never thought we'd see this.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. In the ring, being accompanied by Marianna, he weighs in at 250 pounds.
So Meat and Marianna, and it was last week on Raw as we showed you. Meat and Marianna making out behind the Raw set. GTV caught him. Marianna, this man's, I guess, former girlfriend.
Terry
And can you imagine what Chaz has gone through emotionally this week, seeing his girlfriend making out with Meat on TV? Imagine how the guys have been ribbing him in the locker room.
Imagine seeing your girlfriend playing tonsil hockey with another guy on GTV. Talk about demoralizing, but it looks as if Chaz is really just taking it out on Meat here instead of worrying about what could be a broken-up relationship with Marianna.
Oh, what a right hand by Chaz. You know, I really can't blame Meat. He was humiliated and treated like a dog by Terry. I guess he was just looking for some loving from somebody else.
I don't know, thought he was getting treated pretty well. She was always serving up the treats to him.
And Chaz now hammering away on Meat in the corner. Marianna pleading with him, with Chaz, that is. Meat was in action last night on WWF. Jack didn't fare too well against the Big Red Machine, Kane.
Well, certainly Kane has been red hot, no pun intended. The emotional situation, tugging and pulling with X-Pac as of late.
Oh!
And certainly their relationship is in some question after SmackDown last Thursday.
And look at Chaz now to the midsection of Meat. Coming up next, folks, here on Heat, Deja Video. Did you get a chance, Kevin, to see last week's? It featured the Undertaker and Mankind, the Hell in a Cell match from King of the Ring last year.
And tonight, we're going to take a look at Stone Cold Steve Austin behind the wheel. From the Zamboni to the beer truck, you're going to relive it all here in just a few minutes. It's going to be great.
And Chaz has been dominating Meat. Now a few choice words for Marianna. And he better concentrate on this match here. Marianna can't believe it.
Well, if you think about it, Michael, I mean, Chaz made a very bold career decision not too long ago on the urging of his then-girlfriend, Marianna. So Chaz's life is completely turned upside down. Now he's alone.
Marianna now on the apron of the ring, still arguing with Chaz. And can Meat take advantage here? Oh, what a clothesline.
You know, it seems no matter what happens, Michael, men will always say women can be nothing but trouble sometimes. Certainly Mr. Ass and China, former friends, they've had their problems as of late.
Yeah, but the bottom line is, Kevin, is that China's the number one contender for the Intercontinental Championship. She meets Jeff Jarrett for the title 3 weeks from tonight at Unforgiven.
Certainly China could look very good in gold. We'll see what happens at Unforgiven.
And don't forget, tomorrow night, Raw is War, special time, 11 Eastern, delayed because of the U.S. Open here on USA. Same normal time on the West Coast. It's going to be a battle to determine the number one contenders for the tag team titles, the Acolytes versus Edge and Christian.
Certainly the Dudley boys, who we'll see a little bit later on in the hour, have a lot of interest in the outcome of that match tomorrow night.
Sidewalk slam by Meade, who's taking control of this match now. Over Chaz. Can't wait. Deja Video coming up next here on Sunday Night Heat. Nobody home. Meat. And look at this. Oh, what a kick by Chaz. Deja Video featuring Stone Cold Steve Austin. Road Rage coming up next.
Chaz pummeling away on Meat here.
Do you blame the guy, though?
No, not at all.
And look at Marianna.
Boy, she's got a lot of nerve.
She just grabbed Chaz's foot. And Meat now from behind. Kick to the back of the leg. Referee saw it. It's going to call for the bell. And look out. Here's up Terry. Catfight. Slapping Marianna. Terry just. Wow.
Wait a minute. Marianna's going back after Terry.
And again, Terry. And again. Terry going after Marianna on the ramp. And here we go. The fur is flying. The mascara. Week as well on Raw. GTV not only embarrassed Meat and Marianna, it embarrassed Terry as well. Chaz pulling Terry off. Terry's lost it.
This match result of a disqualification. Chaz!
Can't we all just get along? Chaz picked up the win after the disqualification. Don't go away. Deja Video. Stone Cold coming up on Sunday Night Heat.
Probably my favorite thing was the monster truck, just because this thing was so powerful. I got to tear up a perfectly good 1998 Lincoln Continental.
Magic the Gathering presents WWF Unforgiven, live September 26th from Charlotte, North Carolina. Magic the Gathering, the trading card game, the ultimate battle of wits. Now, let's throw the gears into reverse for Deja Video as we take a look back at Stone Cold Steve Austin's road rage.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, our cameras are in place. We await the arrival of Rattlesnake at any time.
He's not going to come.
I got something to lose. I'm going all out to do. Never stop. I refuse to play by the rules. I'm tight when you're stepping into the night.
this is going to get real interesting.
Give me a hell yeah.
Man, I've gotten to drive just about everything, you know, to the ring here with the World Wrestling Federation.
There's one vehicle that stands out in my mind, Springfield, Massachusetts. There's a match against The Rock and Steve Austin. The whole nation was out there, and I got introduced to a truck.
Here comes CeeLo.
Never forget that Austin vehicle, ever. And that's probably one of the big things on his highlight reel is D'Lo Brown flying through the air. D'Lo Brown, windshield.
Did you see that?
The thing I did with the Zamboni was a lot of fun.
Don't let him in here! Stone Cold! Stone Cold is here! Get your guns out! He's gonna crash Big Man Party!
Because I remember one of the guys in the back that worked in the building was looking at him like he was crazy. Because one of the big light fixtures that they use for interviews actually got hooked on the Zamboni, and he drug it all the way out of the building. It broke into a million pieces. And it was really funny just to see him just utterly run over equipment like that, man. That's Steve Austin, though.
It wasn't necessarily the fastest, most powerful thing I've driven to the ring, but it had a flat hood so I could run off the edge of it and hit Mr. McMahon with a clothesline in the ring.
Oh, yeah! Austin got McMahon! Austin got McMahon! Austin's raising hell!
How come he gets to drive all the cool stuff?
It's a giant limousine!
That thing was about 400 horsepower, but it was two-wheel drive. And I was going to crash over, jump a car. I said, well, you know, where's his safety harnesses or whatever? He goes, oh, we got no seatbelt. I said, well, what do you do? He goes, why would you get ready to hit the cars? Got to grab the steering wheel like this and to tilt your head over it so you don't bounce your head off the roof.
He's done so many things, man. It's, all of them was just great, you know, stuff that you don't expect to see at a wrestling show.
He's right.
Now get your ass out of here because I got some work to do and I want to check my equipment out.
I knew it, Darren's going to try to drive it right in here. Get ready to run. It doesn't look like he's going to run over it. Wait a minute. Oh, my God, I don't believe this. Oh, my God. McMahon's party. Poor man. One of his collections is being destroyed by the rattlesnake. No!
I remember the beer truck. Probably the beer truck was my favorite.
Wait a minute. What the hell? Beer truck.
Yeah, that was fun. It got almost knocked down part of the Raw set.
Wait a minute, King! Austin's driving the beer truck! No call! Yeah! Operation a beer man! You gotta be kidding me!
The big Three Stooges Keystone Cop scene with Vince slipping and sliding the beard.
They gotta think this guy's gotta be out of his mind, which maybe he is.
I kind of pulled a rib on myself because I didn't show it on camera. While I had my finger on the nozzle, I was gonna give myself a drink. And if I still had my tonsils, it probably would have washed them down my throat. It kind of caught me off guard.
The rattlesnake has struck again! I think he must be drunk!
I just so happened to be standing out back when he took the monster truck.
That's awesome. What the hell is that? My God, it's a monster truck!
Probably my favorite thing was the monster truck, just because this thing was so powerful. I got to tear up a perfectly good 1998 Lincoln Continental.
I enjoyed that thoroughly. I would love, I'm a country boy at heart, and I'd love to have been doing that myself.
The rattlesnake coming our way! Austin's driving that monster truck right in here to the arena! Listen to the ovation!
At one point, that thing has 2,500 horsepower. One time I gassed it, I punched it, and one of the camera guys was right there in front of me, and it yanked with the four-wheel drive system. It just yanked the carpet right out from under him. That guy took a crash landing.
It happened so fast, I didn't know where I was. It was like, how did this happen? I was on my back, and I was like, I didn't know how I got there. And I looked at Austin, and I saw he had his hand, like right here. And I didn't know if he was trying not to laugh or, you know, is this guy all right or what happened? Because it was just, you know, I think he couldn't believe what happened either.
Anything you put me in there, I can drive anything on wheels. And hopefully I can drive a few more things also.
I think he needs to drive a moped because that would truly make him the toughest SOB.
When my gears are still turned, if I can come up with some kind of interesting twist, then I'll sure buzz WWF about it and let them know.
All right. Thank you very much.
next week on...
Oh, my God! He's got to be 20 feet off the floor. Yeah. No! No! Mr. McMahon! McMahon fell 20 feet off the steel cage through the Spanish announce table.
If you want me to finish this can of whoop-ass, give me a hell yeah!
What?
You want to know why? I hate everyone. I hate everything.
This is absolute carnage.
There's gonna be pain.
This is a savage, brutal attack.
It's a time for pure, unadulterated hatred and evil. The most dominating force ever. We will take what we want, and we will destroy what we want.
I don't think the 82nd Airborne can fight off the Big Show and the Undertaker.
What used to be known as SummerSlam will now be known as Armageddon. Armageddon! Be afraid. Be very afraid.
X-Pac and Kane have this capacity crowd standing on their feet. Yes, indeed, it will be the greatest challenge of the careers of X-Pac and Kane here. X-Pac knows that he could be the offensive focus of this match. And here we go. Tag team titles on the line. Big Show. The Undertaker obviously thinks the Big Show had X-Pac pinned after the chokeslam. The Undertaker and the Big Show have just become the WWF Tag Team Champions.
Yeah. Big Show wants something. He wants the knowledge that I possess. But if he wants it, he's got to earn it. When Big Show realizes that he's a killer, then there will be nobody left in this ring. You want the knowledge? Then act like it.
That should fire him up. That's motivation for you.
No mercy. Big Show, you do something that is without a shadow of a doubt the most impressive thing The Rock has ever seen, and that's this.
Hey, hold on. No, oh, man. The force of that choke slam was off the page, and here comes Mankind. But the Big Show and the Undertaker are dismantling Mankind.
You two jabronis, you face The Rock in a handicap match. Mankind would like to become the people's partner.
The Rock, Mankind against the Undertaker and the Big Show. Tag titles on the line. How will Mankind and The Rock coexist here tonight?
When I am weakest, I am still stronger than you. When I am weakest, I am still stronger than you. When I am weakest, I am still stronger than you. When I am weakest, I am still stronger than you.
Paul Bearer showed The Undertaker something. I don't know what it was. What was it? Is The Undertaker turning his back on his tag partner? The Rock gonna let the SmackDown. He just hit it on the green monster.
Champion.
Welcome back to Sunday Night Heat here on USA. One thing is for certain here in the WWF, the competition to become the number one contender for the WWF Tag Team titles has reached another level. And last Monday night, that was evident as four teams battled in a Four Corners elimination match to determine who would gain that coveted number one spot. Then all hell broke loose.
And here's Fistra, what are they? And Meanie and another tag team not in this competition. There's Cross and Prince Albert. Wait a minute, that's 16. Stevie Richards and the Blue Meanie. Another team. That's the 17. Oh, I'll tell you what, somebody's going to get hurt bad here. We got the referees throwing a ring up. Dang, this match is completely out of control.
Nothing was settled on Raw, so WWF officials set up a 17 tag team turmoil match with Royal Rumble rules on SmackDown, hoping that once and for all, we would have number one contenders.
Edge and Christian to the ring. Here we go. The last team to enter, tag team turmoil. And whoever wins this match here, folks, we'll get a shot at the tag team title. Wait a minute. King the Dudley boys. Bubba Ray and D-Von are here. And D-Von and Bubba Ray making a statement here.
Thou shalt not mess with the Dudleys.
So once again, no number one contender was decided. So this Monday night on Raw, WWF officials have made a match. It'll be Edge and Christian taking on the Acolytes, with the winners earning the right to become number one contenders for the tag team titles. Lillian Garcia is standing by with one of those teams, the Acolytes. Lillian?
Acolytes, Edge and Christian feel pretty confident that tomorrow night on Raw, they're going to defeat you to become the number one contender for the tag team title.
You know, here we go again. They bring two new punk asses in here for us to beat the hell out of. You know, it looks like the more ass we kick around here, the stupider they get. Edge and Christian, you just don't get it. After Raw, not only will you be missing talent, you're going to be missing body parts as well.
I guess you're new around here, honey, just like the Dudleys. So let me introduce ourselves. This is Farouk. I am Bradshaw. We are the Hunters. You don't hunt the Hunters. So you tell the Dudleys. Look forward to seeing them again.
Hey, Dudley boys, I don't know how wise it was to enter the WWF by kicking off the Acolytes. The Acolytes are not exactly a very nice greeting party, but they're certainly ready to say hello to the Dudleys.
In the ring at a combined weight of 545 pounds, Stevie Richards and the Blue Meanie.
Folks, something big is coming to USA. Get ready to enter the center. USA joins forces with Hallmark Entertainment to bring you Treat Williams and Jeremy London in Journey to the Center of the Earth.
And
Journey to the Center of the Earth premieres Tuesday, September 14th, 8 p.m., 7 Central, right here on USA.
And Devon, the Dudley Boys.
Let me get this straight. Meanie's from Pepperland, and the Dudley Boys are from Dudleyville.
Right.
Devon and Bubba Ray, they're brothers. I'll tell you what, the Dudley boys have really thrown a wrench into this tag team situation here in the WWF.
Strong family resemblance.
Yeah, sure. So it's the Dudley boys against Meanie and Stevie Richards here on Sunday Night Heat. And Kevin, can you ever remember when the competition within the tag team ranks has been as competitive as it is now?
I mean, you've got new tag team champions in Mankind and The Rock, the Acolytes, of course, Edge and Christian, the New Brood, Draws and Prince Albert, Midi and Viscera, Stevie Richards and the Blue Meanie here. What about the Hardcore Hollies? Talk about dysfunctional.
Yeah, dysfunctional. Always want to fight each other, but I'll tell you what, this past week on SmackDown, they proved that when they work together, they're a formidable tag team.
As are the Dudleys, folks, who can come to us from ECW. We're about to see them here for the first time. D-Von makes the tag to Bubba Ray. Very strong teamwork of what the Dudleys are all about.
Bubba Ray hammering away on the Blue Meanie. Made their presence felt, interfering in the tag team turmoil match on SmackDown. Still don't have a number one contender for the tag team titles, but that may be solved on Raw tomorrow night when the Acolytes meet Edge and Christian. And don't forget, Raw comes to you delayed 11 o'clock Eastern on the East Coast, normal time on the West Coast because of the U.S. Open right here on USA. Stevie Richards now into the ring, kicking away at Bubba Ray, the Dudley Boys.
Stevie Richards has done more for Daisy Duke Shorts than, well, anybody since Daisy Duke.
I think Terry has done something for Daisy Duke Shorts. Look at Stevie Richards now whipped into the corner by Bubba Ray. And the Dudley Boys, wow, what a shot. Tag team champions now rocking Mankind. We've talked about it. What an unlikely team. And don't forget, we're only months removed from the wars between these two. The halftime Heat Super Bowl battle. How about the battle for the I Quit match? Last man standing, all for the WWF title.
Well, they're going to have to put their history behind them, or their reign as tag team champions will be history in a very short order. Elbow to the sternum by Bubba Ray and the Dudley Boyz now, putting a hurt on Stevie Richards and the Blue Meanie. Here comes Devon.
Well, if the authorities are going to look for Bubba Ray Dudley, they can get fingerprints from Stevie Richards' chest.
Devon screaming at Stevie Richards. You know, the Dudley Boyz making their name by being hardcore, so to speak. Rough and tough tag team. Oh, man.
Michael, though, that's just the minimum requirements for entry here in the World Wrestling Federation. You want to talk about hardcore? What about what the Big Boss Man did to Al Snow?
The Boss Man serving up Al Snow's pet as dinner. Boss Man is sick. He's sadistic.
I don't think Al Snow's ever going to be the same again. But really, I mean, what the Big Boss Man did, folks, absolutely off the page.
You get an update tomorrow night on Raw's War about the Al Snow situation. Remember, 11 o'clock Eastern delayed because of the U.S. Open. Look at this now. Stevie Richards picks him over and a two count before a kick out. And, oh man, clothesline by Devon.
Devon's very athletic. He was first to his feet. He put Stevie Richards down.
Stevie Richards really needs to make a tag here to the Blue Meanie. Crowd starting to come alive a little bit for Stevie Richards. Wow.
Ooh.
And Devon, total control, and here comes Bubba Ray.
Nasty jawbreaker.
Double team now by the Dudley Boyz. No, it isn't. Bubba Ray going to go one-on-one with Stevie Richards, and the Southpaw goes to work now with left hands to the chin. Referee Teddy Long. Oh, misses with a closed fist now. Oh, and what a kick. Stevie kick right to the chin, and you can hear that echo throughout the arena. And Blue Meanie now waiting for a tag from Stevie Richards, and Bubba Ray didn't know what hit him. So quick with the Stevie kick. And here comes Devon, here comes Blue Meanie, here we go now. Devon misses right hand, Meanie to the eyes of Bubba Ray. Another right hand, and the Blue Meanie now hammering away on the Dudley Boyz. Bubba Ray off the ropes, Meanie hits him with a clothesline. Blue Meanie almost fell down with the force of that. Here comes Devon, Meanie catches him with a clothesline.
The Blue Meanie's on fire.
Bubba Ray whipped into the corner. Look out. Here we go now. Dudley Boyz pancake.
A family moment for the Dudleys.
Oh, man, oh, man. Bubba Ray right in the lower extremities of Devon. Cover now. Two. And Bubba Ray makes the save with a right hand to Meanie.
You know, you got to give it up for the Dudley Boyz. They got the right attitude. They chose SmackDown, the opportunity for their debut. And, of course, now wanting to accomplish great things here on Heat. But, Michael, they're getting worn out by the Blue Meanie and Stevie Richards.
And Bubba Ray and Devon, recipients of right hands. And look out now! What a counter by Bubba Ray! And Blue Meanie doesn't realize that Stevie Richards has been knocked down. Meanie off the ropes now. Devon lifts him up. What a double team!
The Dudley Death Drop!
Bubba Ray hooks the leg. This one's over, folks. Impressive debut on Heat for the Dudley Boyz.
Here are your winners, the Dudley Boyz.
I hope the words of Farouk and Bradshaw are ringing in the Dudley's ears. The welcoming committee's on its way, boys.
Stick around. We're coming back with more Heat. The Big Show just clobbered Paul Bearer. Finkel's in the trunk. He's in the trunk.
And Mankind right on the table.
Thursdays will never be the same. Don't miss SmackDown, Thursdays at 8 Eastern, 7 Central.
Sunday Night Heat. Just a reminder to our fans on the East Coast and in the Midwest, tomorrow night, Raw is War will be delayed 2 hours due to U.S. Open tennis. So Raw kicks off at 11 p.m. Eastern, 10 p.m. Central tomorrow night. And everyone on the West Coast, Raw airs at its regular time of 9 p.m. And now, without further ado, it's the WWF's version of Plays of the Week. So bring it on.
The fur is flying here on Raw. Get back. Reaper Goldo.
Mankind would like
like to become the people's partner.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
Don't you ever steal The Rock's phrases again.
And I wonder, day to day, I don't like you anyway. I don't need your case today. You're pathetic in your own way. I feel for you in a bigger way. I will behave and you can go.
You're busted!
He got busted all right.
Yeah. The champion in the ring! Set Mr. Ass
up! If you smell! La, la, la. What did The Rock just tell you?
He's an idiot!
Nick's a great guy.
The Big Show just clobbered Paul Bearer! Finkel's in the trunk! He's in the trunk!
And Mankind right out of the...